Going on, guys, welcome back to another Minecraft mod showcase, and today I am showcasing the Witchery mod. And this mod would be perfect for our Fellowship series as it's magical, and you guys will see that it is perfect for that. So if we can hit, I set 2000 for our last light goal, so I'm going to set it 3000 this time because you guys destroyed it last time. So 3000 if you want to see this in a Fellowship series, and if even if you just enjoyed the video and you want to give it a thumbs up, that'll be really cool. So let's crack on with the mod. It adds three new decorative tree blocks. You've got the Hawthorn, the Alder, and Rowan, which I don't know if I showed you at the front, but those are what they look like. Pretty bog standard sort of looking trees. They're kind of cool. Got some interesting little leaf decorations. There's some of this, which is Spanish moss, which is required for a recipe. I don't know if you heard that. There's a crow outside my room, and he just won't bugger off. I'm just going to time set, because we don't want any crows coming in game. So I'm going to crack up with some of the items which is required for the witchery itself. A soft clay jar, which is crafted like this, and then you put it in a furnace to make a clay jar. That's required when you're using a distillery. Can you hear him? What a bastard. So a distillery is crafted like this, with an attuned stone, gold ingots, and clay jars. The attuned stone is crafted like this, with a whiff of magic, which is crafted in a witch's oven. Now, to make a witch's oven, which is this chap here, you need iron ingots, iron bars, and a bucket. So that one's quite simple. Now, in a witch's oven, you use oak saplings as the fuel source, or you could use blaze rods. Saplings are the best if you're going to get yourself one of these magical things, though. So basically, you put wood in, it turns it into coal, and there's a chance that the clay jar is going to get filled and turn into one of these here. So, foul fume, exhale of the horned one, breath of the goddess, hint of rebirth, whiff of magic, reek of misfortune, and odor of purity. Now, in a distillery, you can craft yourself, if you use the recipes here, with clay jars, oil of vitroil, and a diamond, you can get three different things. And so it's basically, if you use the distilling guides, there's a collecting fumes, brews and infusions, and a circle magic guide. There's loads of guides, they're really good. There's in fact a wiki, which is on the forum thread in the description, which is a beautiful wiki. Wikis these days, I swear I'm saying this every time, is wikis are so good today. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll show you what they look like. That's the distillery, and that is the witch's oven. Now on top is a filtered fume funnel, which is crafted like this, with a fume filter, with a tuned stone charge, some glass and iron ingots, and the fume funnel itself is crafted with buckets and lava and glowstone iron blocks. Kind of expensive, but it will speed up the actual oven process, so that bar will just a lot faster, which is pretty nice. Fast is good. Now the puppets. I thought it was puppets at first. So for the first day of setting this up, I was calling it puppets, because this took a long time to set up. This is a complex mod, but I love it. It's like Ars Magica for dummies, but cooler. It's hard to explain, because Ars Magica, I struggled to get my head around it. It's a lot very time consuming. This is very interesting, really quick and fun magic. So the puppet shelf, which is crafted like this, with a tuned stone, nether bricks, and a wool in the center, or green wool. And then you craft yourself a poppet. Now poppets are, they're like voodoo dolls pretty much, and you stuff them with certain things, and then the DNA of the person you want to curse or heal or whatever inside the poppet. So say for the earth protection, you're going to use dirt with the poppet, which is crafted using that Spanish moss and a bone needle, which is just a bone and flint and steel. And then say feathers, so that's the earth protection. That one's going to protect you from falling, so you've got earth and feathers, so it's like giving you wings. You've got the water, protect you from drowning, water artichoke, which you grown or found. So yeah, there's all kinds of recipes all on the forums. And what you do then is craft yourself the taglock kit, which I showed you, a bone needle and a glass bottle, and then get yourself, so use the earth protection, the taglock kit, and then once you've slept in a bed, you're going to all say that's Cody's bed. I'd right click on Cody's bed with the tag lock kit, and it says Jobuzz now. It's got my DNA in it. And then in a crafting table, you put that, that next to the poppet you want to give the name to, if that makes any sense. So now it says Jobuzz on it. So if I get up into the air, well into the air, hopefully this is going to work. I'm praying this is going to work. And this one is going to protect you from all fall damage. So if I game mode 0, there we go. The poppet actually disappeared, but I'm alive. So if you had a load of those in your inventory, I'm not sure if it's just hotbar only. Probably is. But if you did have them and you're on a high cliff, get your poppet out, put it in your hotbar, and you'll be safe from falling, which is really cool. So yeah, there's all kinds of different ones. Now there's this, the Arthana, and this is useful in getting three things. The Witch's Hand, which is now a drop if you use the Arthana on a witch. And that's, I think it gives you some brewing bonuses and things like that, and it looks kind of funky. If you guys haven't noticed yet, I have a cape. That is the Minecon 2013 cape. If you haven't seen it yet, it's pretty nifty. So yeah, that hand's pretty creepy. The Arthana is crafted like this. Quite simple. Just an emerald and some gold stuffs. You can also get cobwebs. If you slash the cobweb, you won't get string. You'll actually get a cobweb if you use the Arthana. And skeleton skull. You can get that from drops from skeleton if you kill a skeleton with the Arthana. Which is pretty nice because you're going to need the skull for the altar, which is over here. Now, for these, which are dream catchers, they have various effects and you put them above your bed. So if I time set night, because this one is closest to me, and this, it is the dream weaver of nightmares. So this one's closest to my bed. So if I sleep in my bed, I'll wake up feeling like crap because this one is not a good one. It gives you nausea, so I'm going to get that milk really fast and get rid of this hell. Stop. There we go. Oh, Jesus, that's horrible. So there's three other ones, which are, you can't see when you use the mouse scroll, the fasting, iron arm, and fleet foot. So the fasting is prevents hunger for a certain amount of time when you wake up. The which was that one? Iron arm will give you a mining buff, and the fleet foot will give you a speed buff when you wake up. It only lasts a certain time, but you just put them up near or above your bed. So just put it there, for example. But that's kind of glitch. That's weird. But yeah, and you wake up with that buff, which is very nice. Very nice indeed. Let's get rid of all of this. Now I'm going to go on to altars. So there's an altar over here. And the altar is crafted like so. And it'll give you three. You need to do this twice because you need six blocks. And once you put the blocks together, for the final sixth one in, it'll put a red carpet on the top. And it'll charge up. So this one I've put on top an alluring skull, a chalice, a full chalice, and a torch. Now you can also put these chandelabre on. I don't actually know how to craft the chandelabre. I don't know. It doesn't give me a recipe for that one. But the alluring skull, which is crafted just like this, is not too difficult, but it is one of the best buffs apart from the wither skull. Now the altar is crafted, as I was saying, like this, with breath of goddess and exhale of the horned one, with some rowan wood blocks and some stone brick and a bottle of water. So you need to do that twice and you get yourself an altar. Now, it's not only the things you put on the top which affect the total amount of power the altar can get to, it's also trees and things around the outside. Now, if you look out here, it took me a while to figure this out. I had to do a bit of wiki. It's got the altar here and I've got some magical around it. It looks pretty funky. And I've got these trees I had to plant because I wasn't reaching maximum capacity, even though this is the ultimate setup for an altar. So I've got 4,000 in there, which is, I believe, the maximum. I could be wrong, but I think that is the maximum. I couldn't get it any higher. So next chest, we have some ritual chalk. And I'll show you these. These are outside, already on the floor. And you have the gold, the white, and there's the otherwear chalk, infernal chalk. So it's not the gold. Yeah, it is the golden one. And that's what they look like when you place them on the floor. So they're pretty funky. They change all the time what they actually look like. So you see that one's slightly different, which is a nice feature, just a bit of randomness. And those are used for like summoning circles. which I'll show you later too. So brooms and enchanted brooms, those will also come later. You need to use the altar to enchant things. So the enchanted broom obviously is going to fly. The broom has very little use unless it is enchanted. Now these are pretty cool. The water diviner and the lava diviner. And I've got a bit of lava over here under the stone. And what you're going to use is you're digging straight down. You're panicking. You need to get out of this place. Wherever the hell you are, you need to go straight down. Which is the number one rule of Minecraft. You don't dig straight down. But if you have this, you can right click above the block and say I'm over here. Right click, nothing. Because under there is nothing. If I right click here, it'll give this little particle effect, and underneath is lava. And the same will happen for water, which is really cool. A nice way of finding some water. So yeah, that's really useful if you are in a tight spot and you're sort of crapping yourself as you dig down. These are all just ingredients for using in the kettle, which is this chap over here, which is crafted like this, with a tune stone, cauldron, things like that. I've just set it up so it looks like this. These are just walls. And there's a nether rack underneath, Rack City, which I've set on fire to heat the kettle up. And those are all just ingredients for it. If you want to go into the ingredients of making certain things, then it's all on the forums, all on their wonderful wiki, so go do that. Next is these circle talismans, which are pretty much just ways of, as you saw earlier, the circle magic I created. I had to do that by hand and using the wiki. You can use these circle talismans to trap these magic circles and deploy them really fast if you're out in the field. So if you're miles away from your home and you don't have time to get your chalk out and use all a million pieces of chalk, you can get one of these circles and quickly enchant your stuff, get a broom, fly home and do things properly. There's also the Polonese charm and the Devil's Tongue charm. I'm not actually sure what these do, but the Polonese charm tells me it talks to animals, and the Devil's Tongue charm, even demons find your wit irresistible most of the time. There's also the witch's hat, witch's robes, and the necromancer robes. The witch's hat is crafted like so with impregnated leather, which is crafted with whiffs of magic and a diamond vapor, so it's pretty expensive. But it does give you this sort of boost. I can't remember, one of the machines that I showed you gives you a boost for that. It's decent, I think, leatherish type of protection. And the necromancer, they look pretty good on. I'm going to get those out ready for when I'm actually flying on my broom. So what else have we got in here? We covered everything. I think we pretty much covered everything in here, apart from the poppet shelf. Now you can put your poppets in there, and they all go in there and just spin. That looks really funky. I like that. So outside, out into the magical world. So I showed you this. These are all just plants you can grow. So these are water ones, water artichokes. So you just put the seeds on the water and they turn into water artichokes. These are belladonnas, and these are mandrakes. Is it mandrakes? Were they the ones that screamed in Harry Potter? I can't really remember. I think they might have been. Now this is the triffid. So I'm going to need myself a hoe. This guy's in a chest because we need to be protected from this guy. So let's put three of them down. And oh my goodness, they're alive. If you've ever seen the War of the Worlds, the blood sort of things, I believe those are based on triffids. I think triffids are from a completely different book entirely. Oh Jesus. But they're plants, pretty much alien plants that come to life and feed on human blood, I believe, which is not too pleasant, but it does have a dark side, this mod. I've just got to get rid of these guys because they're quite noisy. Come on chap, die triffid. There we go, dead. And he drops a rose, as you'd expect from a triffid. Probably not, but anyway, next we have these, which are in fact void brambles. And void brambles are the bane of this mod review for me, because I placed them down, had no idea what they did, and walked into one. It sends you 500 blocks, up to 500 blocks, in any direction. And I hadn't set spawn, I just set everything up, so it took me ages to find my stuff. It's a perfect defense mechanism for people who don't know what's going on, new people to the server, you want to protect your house. This is perfect for it. So now we have the flower traps, and I've got four of them up here, and they're crafted like so, with pressure plates, the flower itself, and a special concoction which is using a splash potion. You need three of them, and they're crafted with those special recipes which I showed you in the chest over there. So first off we have this, which is a rose of webs. Walk into it and pretty much web mania, just explodes with webs. Next we have this. They all come in, like, say you can get it all in dandelion, or you can get it all in shrubs. Just, there's only four different types of actual explosions, or I guess you call them explosion. This one, next one is, where's not telling me what it is. It's telling me a rose of webs again, but it's not. It's the ink one. So yeah, that one just gives you blindness for about 17 seconds, I believe that might have been. Next one is the, what was this one? Prickliness? I can't remember. Thorns. The thorns. It just makes a big old cacti. And yeah, that will ruin your day a little bit. Now this one's pretty cool. If I drop right on top, boom! I actually saw a cow set this off a little while ago, and it was right at the top. This is the one, I think, sprouting maybe? Yeah, sprouting. It just puts this massive sort of log with the bit of leaf on it. Bit of leafy? A leafage? So next we're going to go on to probably my favourite part of the mod, and this is actual, like, enchantment magic. Serious magic. So I'm going to just use one enchantment because there's so many, and you are going to want to do it yourself when we add it to a mod pack, or when you download it straight after this video, because this is the craziest mod ever. So pretty much create the circle from the recipe you'll find. So there's a little gold chalk in the center, and this one is the ritual glyphs. No, it's not. What's the chalk called? It's the ritual chalk. Okay, fair enough. And you need to plant some trees, as I said. You don't actually do anything with the altar. So I'm going to use So the recipe for this spell is a broom and this stuff, which is flying ointment, which is crafted like so with all those recipes. And you... or ingredients, even. I've been saying recipes for a while, thinking that doesn't quite make sense. Now, throw the broom in the inner circle, and then on the other side, or next to the broom, throw in the ointment, and it's got to be night, so time set 16,000, and then right click on the yellow bit. But why? Why? Is it this stuff? Is it this? Is this stuff? Is this stuff blocking my stuffs? No. Come on, don't do this to me. Oh, crap. There we go. It was that stuff. So that stuff prevents the magic from happening. So it sucks him in, both of them, one at a time, and spits out the enchanted broom. So that's the enchanted broom. Up, and there we go. Where you look, it will fly. So it took me ages to get actually up in the air, because I was trying to go up with space. But yeah, if you look up, you'll go up. And in F5, it looks really awesome. So if I put my witch's gear on... Oh, what a sexy chicken. It actually looks like I've got a wand too. That is magical. So, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you want to check out the mod, the link will be in the description. And thanks for watching.